In Lesson 5.6, students refer back to Lesson 5.5 to think about the M&M they saw dissolving in room temperature water. And the question they investigate in this lesson, 5.6, is, does the temperature of water affect the amount of coating that dissolves from an M&M? The science concepts covered are that temperature does affect the solubility of a substance, that each substance has its own characteristic solubility at a given temperature, and that faster-moving molecules increase the number and force of the contacts that the solvent has with the solute, which makes it dissolve faster. And the other important thing is that students design a scientific experiment, so they deal with identifying and controlling variables. So you ask students to help design an experiment to see if temperature affects the amount of dissolving from an M&M. So students should come up with ideas like, you need to use the same amount of water in the same type of cup, you need to use the same color M&M because the color might matter, but you need to put them in at the same time and in the same way. The only thing that should be different is the temperature, because that's what we're trying to find out. Does temperature have an effect on the dissolving of the coating of the M&M? For this experiment, students put the M&M in at the same time in cold, room temperature, and hot water in the center of the cup, but they don't swirl. They just let the water dissolve the M&M to the extent that it will based on the temperature. And they see that in the hot water, most of the M&M coating dissolved. In the room temp, some dissolved, but not as much as in the hot. And in the cold, very little dissolved, but some did. Here you can discuss why that happened. It has to do with the speed and the force at which the water molecules contact the sugar and food coloring on the M&M. You can make an argument that in hot water, water molecules are moving very quickly, they hit the sugar harder, and that more water molecules hit in a given amount of time, so you're going to have more dissolving. And in room temp, a little less, and in cold, even a little less. One thing that students will notice is that there's a bigger difference between room temperature and hot than there is between cold and room temperature. That's mostly because there's a larger difference in temperature between room temp and hot. The hot water might be as much as 70 degrees centigrade or so. The room temperature water is about 20, so that's a 50 degree difference. But the cold, if you use ice water, will be near 5 degrees or so. So between 5 and 20 is only a 15 degree difference, but between 20 and, let's say, 70 could be a 50 degree difference. So there's probably going to be a bigger difference in the dissolving between room temp and hot than there is between cold and room temp. You can also show students that not every substance is affected the same way by temperature as sugar is, the sugar in the candy coating of the M&M. If you look at sugar dissolved in water here, it's dissolved in cold water here and in hot water in this graduated cylinder, and a lot more dissolves in the hot than in the cold. But if you look at salt, the difference between the cold water and the hot water for dissolving the salt isn't that different. It's pretty similar. So a little bit more salt dissolves in hot than in cold, but not much. But in sugar, there's a much bigger difference. A lot more dissolves in hot than in cold. We also include a graph, a solubility curve, so that students can see what happens with sugar. At low temperatures, a certain amount of sugar dissolves. Here it's about 175 grams, let's say, in 100 mils of water at 0 degrees. But as you increase the temperature of the water, a lot more sugar will dissolve. But for salt, as you increase the temperature of the water, only a bit more salt dissolves than sugar. So different substances act differently. In general, almost every substance that's soluble dissolves more in hot than in cold, but the extent to which they dissolve more or less is different depending on the substance. We also give students a chart of the solubility of potassium chloride so that they can create their own curve to see how potassium chloride dissolves compared with sugar and salt. So if you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1.1, which says, develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. Well, Lesson 5.6 relates to this performance expectation, mainly because students have already seen that water can dissolve sugar. They've seen a model of sucrose, and they've seen a model of water and how they interact. But on top of that, they're adding this idea of temperature. If the water molecules move faster, what would be the result? So the idea is to extend that model that they have already dealt with to understand the effect of temperature on solubility. If you look at the foundation boxes, students develop a model to predict or describe phenomena. In this case, the phenomena is this faster dissolving of sugar in hot water. What's the model that explains that? What's this faster moving water molecules hitting the sugar more often and harder? They also learn that substances are made of different types of atoms, which combine with one another in different ways. They've already seen that in sugar and salt, but they also see that they have characteristic physical properties in that they are soluble to different extents and that temperature affects the solubility differently. And for cross-cutting concepts, scale, proportion, and quantity, again, this idea that students are explaining a macroscopic phenomena, this faster or slower dissolving or more or less dissolving, by referring all the way down to the submicroscopic molecular level to understand the phenomena. So, thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.